Sri Deva Purisha Mahadeva Dayala. Sri Deva Purisha Mahadeva Dayala.
So our Swami Haripuriji, and he is a very great sadhu. You know that he is a very, very humble, kind. If you want to learn from him.
Om bole Shri Dev Purusha Mahadeva ki jai. Shri Deep Narayan Bhagwan ki jai. Shri Alakh Purusha Bhagwan ki jai. Dharam Samrat Samadavananda ji Bhagwan ki jai. Vishwaguru Mahamandaleshwar Swami Maheshwarananda ji Gurudev ki jai. Parampara Gurudev. As usual, as we know, Swamiji surprised me like he like to surprise, so he surprised me with the lecture now. So it's not prepared, it's just a it's just to say something from my little experience up to now with Vishwaguruji's, as Vishwaguruji's disciple, get trained, different ashrams, mainly small ashrams, similar to Vishwaguruji's talk that about an ashram in the side of the river. So I also spent some time in an ashram like Kailash Ashram that in the past was a river, and in the Nepal Ashram that there is a river, and sometime in Jaipur Ashram and Jadan Ashram. So I want to say something about the small ashrams, because this is my main experience up to now. First of all, I will start that Vishwaguruji is giving satsang and we are giving lecture. So the different we know, and one is Gyani and one is, in my case, Agyani. So take the things with your discrimination, because could be that I will say something that is not agree, so it is very fine, because I am speaking as Agyani, the one that doesn't have the true knowledge. So understand this. So small ashrams, mainly I started in the Kailash Ashram, and this was a great privilege and a great experience. The blessing of the Furuji is very unique and great. And in a small ashram, there is many faces. It's not the ashram that has many faces, it's the person that has many faces. How he takes the ashram, in which attitude he takes the ashram. How serious is he in the seva of this ashram. This is the main thing. It is, can be also a big ashram, but I'm speaking now in a small ashram, so we can speak about this now. So you start the day, it depends on you, how you start the day. It depends on you how you continue the day and how you end the day. So a great discipline needs in a small ashram, because there is program that mainly you do it. Okay, the God is there, he will be there and will lead you, but you need to do to listen, and you need to obey, and he will direct. And if you don't follow, then it's your pity. So you wake up. You decide when you wake up. First, you can put the watch to wake up. After some time, you start to wake up before the watch. And then you say, oh, it's before. So I will wait till the watch will start, because I decided that I will wake up when the watch starts to ring. So this is the point what I want to say. You miss something. Because if you look deeper, you can say, oh, God, you woke me up earlier. So kind of you. Thank you. I will wake up now and I will start the day. Of course, not in too early that you can handle the day. You can be focused and aware. And then you wake up. So either you take shower or not, it's up to you. Either you start with asanas or meditation, it's up to you. How long? If you want to do it, if you start the day with chai or not. So the morning is done, and then the day starts in the meaning of the seva in the ashram. So if you think about to present the ashram nicely, so you need to clean it, because maybe someone will come. But then you say, who comes? Sometimes someone comes in this time, so I can clean later. So you decided to clean later, and then suddenly someone come. This is the God. He said to you, no, your thought was wrong. You were supposed to take care that maybe someone will come. So either you take it serious, you take it as a guidance, you take it as a experience, you take it as a directing. This is up to you. You can say, oh, okay. I didn't. Doesn't matter who he didn't look. Or you say, oops, Gurudev, I will not think like this anymore. I will listen to my inner call that maybe someone will come and I will clean it next time. And then you get routine. Slowly, slowly you get routine. And the routine is also powerful, because once you have routine, you generate energy. Routine is a great tool for generating energy. And if you are tired or not, if you are hungry or not, if you are thirsty or not, you do your routine. And if you break it, this is your pity. So the seva in the ashram is continuing with the puja. So cleaning. Okay, puja, but the statue doesn't see if there is a flower or not. This is one thinking. You're in a small ashram. It's great, Kailash. But this is you who are doing the ashram towards yourself. How you take the ashram is how it is for you. This is the real ashram in you. And one thing is, my God, came to me the information that God nourishes himself with the eyes, with this, the smell. I will find the best smelly flower in the ashram, the beautiful one for you. And you do it. And then you can do it in the nearest bagicha or the farthest bagicha. And then you go to the nearest. And then you find something good, but still, maybe in the other bagicha, in the other field, will be a better one. No, I'm angry already. I want to drink the chai. Let's take it. And you take it. You see, you're lost. This is your ashram. Your ashram, you didn't take it serious. You didn't take your devta, your god, serious. And you gain according to this. It's the daily life of an ashram. The daily life for your attitude towards the spiritual life. And the other one is going to the next bagicha, the next field. And you find a better one, a better flower. Can you imagine the satisfaction of this moment? And you say, God, it was worthy. It's not me. It is you. Thank you. You communicate. You have a relation. You develop inner communication with your God. This is make the life very, very powerful, very, very colorful, very beautiful and very meaningful. And it's leading for success. So you return with it and you present it. How good feeling it is. It is a great feeling. And this feeling is actually, it's not so just a feeling. It is regenerating your cells. It's regenerating your brain. Good feeling is good for health. So you gain health in this moment. You gain blessing in this moment. You gain satisfaction and so many things in this moment. So it's worthy. It's not just that you brought a flower. It has a chain of small successes. Success. It has a chain. And then come the time to make the chai. And you go to the kitchen and you think, oh, I forgot to open now the main gate. It's the time for maybe someone to come. Maybe someone to come. I will make the chai. Someone will come. No, will not come. It's not normal. It never happened. So you make the chai. You make the chai. You take care of the spices. And this much, you're so into it. You already taste it. It is okay. It is okay. But you neglected something. And this is not okay. And someone came. And maybe someone came and left. But this he doesn't know. But he will get to know. Because God is there. He will let you know somehow. Someone will tell you. He will tell you the next time. What's happened? It was not open. You say, I worked up late. I'm sorry, I was working till, making seva till 4 o'clock in the morning, so, you know, it's very hard to wake up early. And maybe it's not true. Or even if it's true, it's not a reason. So this, that the God is there, is very true. And this, that things are getting guided, it is true. So if we listen to it, it is our benefit. If you don't listen to it, you're lost. So you want to be in an ashram? You want to be in a ashram, it means you need to dedicate yourself to an ashram. Then you can get. The more you forget yourself, actually, the more you are there. That I believe. I don't know exactly, but I believe. What means that you are in the puja. So you are in the puja. You don't think about your chai. Means you are in the puja, means you forgot yourself because you don't think about the chai. The chai is representing your desire. The chai is representing yourself, actually. Not the real self, but the false self. That we want something there. So you miss this. And the best way to do it is to be in the present. But we know, but it's so hard to do. That I believe. Again, this is lecture and this is satsang. So this is lecture. So you made the chai. Let's say you did open and suddenly someone came. God, thank you. It was important to open. How good feeling it is. Yes, I did it. God, I did it. You know, you forgot yourself to have the chai. You remember him to serve him. Means you connected to him. Means you were there with him. How colorful life it is to communicate, to see the God's lila in the day. It is there if you take it serious, if you want to achieve. So you continue and come the time for lunch. But before the time of lunch, you have some things to do. But you're already in lunch. What will I cook? Okay, I need to fix this door. It's not good. But what about lunch? Okay, forget about this. And you fix the door, and I need to bring this tool. It's not a proper tool. I will not go now to the workshop. I will do it with this tool. And something happened, a scratch happened. Okay, who looks there? But you say, no, I need the other tool, the other way around. I need the other tool. And you go and bring the tool and you succeed to file the door that it will not make noise on the ground. How nice satisfaction it is. You made it. You did it. It's completed. And maybe another task to do. Oh, it will take me 1 hour. No, but now it's 12:30. At 1 o'clock, normally I'm eating. It will take me 1 hour. Let's go. and then you go. This is your ashram. Your ashram was not serious at this moment. Your ashram thought about yourself. Means you are bounded more to the world and you are not there. Because if you will go to make the seva of half an hour later, you will get. Definitely you will get. 100% you will get. And you cannot measure it in money. You cannot measure it in anything. Because God is gracious. And if you give him, your false self, he will demolish it for you. Well, how can you do it alone? You cannot do it even in your meditation, actually. He will do it for you only because you did the next job. You didn't need to go to, even to, I would dare to say, even to remember to repeat your mantra during the job. No, you do it with full dedication, with full present that I will succeed the next work. Doesn't matter if I have more in this day or not. Maybe something will come more to do. Or actually you have to water the garden because it is hot. So you went to do the next job. And then you forget actually to cook. This is the God. He helped you that moment. Maybe it was in that first job. But in the next job, the next seva, it was not there. Be aware. He did it for you. How great it is. Oh God. Oh God. I wouldn't do it in my japa. You did it. How grateful you are to me. Gracious. I will do it again. So you started something and it inspired you for the next thing. Again, a chain. A good chain. It can be not good chain. But this, I would say, it's a good chain. So you went to the good and not to the pleasant. This is your ashram. Your ashram get filed. Your ashram get perfected. Your ashram get energy. Your ashram get support from him because of your dedication. So more people will come. More people will feel it. More people will respect you because of it. It's not you. It's him. You finish the next job and then you say, I did it. Now it's time to cook. And then you can cook 1 hour or you can cook 30 minutes. For 1 hour you need to cook 2 sabjis and chapatis. But for 1/2 hour you need 1 sabji and chapati. What is enough? But I actually have only bengan and bindi. I like both. I will not cook too much. I will cook little from this and little from this. 1 hour. 1 hour. I will do quickly the chapatis. So you do 2 sabjis and chapatis. And 1 hour gone. From where? From your seva. From maybe from your rest. But not from your rest, because you will take the rest. Means you remember yourself, your false self, not him. Not this that you say to yourself, I can do something more if I cook 1/2 hour. That means you remember him. That means he will pull you to him. Because where is your mind? There you will go. Where is your mind? That you will be. So the more you remember him, the more you him. The more you are there, the more you achieve. The more you in Vairagya. Means he is in Vairagya, so you become Vairagi because you become him. And if he is a Siddha, you become a Siddha because it is him. It takes time. It takes dedication. It takes effort. But the potential is there. So you eat, you finish, you go to rest. I cooked half an hour because I didn't want to lose half an hour for him, for my seva. But my rest is fixed. No. My rest is fixed. This is 1.5 hours. I need it. I need to wake up to repeat your name. Oh, please, please, please. No, you have a debate in you. You are alone in an ashram. Alone in an ashram. That is the benefit that you are communicating innerly. That is a great benefit. You can do it in a big ashram, but it's very hard because there are more people. There is interactions. But in a small ashram, you have you with you and him. Your false self, your real self, and this is him. So you go to rest, 1.5 hours. You put your watch, your alarm clock, and after 1 hour you wake up. What's the time? I didn't hear it. It didn't ring. 1 hour. I want to wake up tomorrow earlier. I should sleep half an hour more. Oh, God. Thank you. You woke me up half an hour earlier. How nice of you. It means I'm not tired anymore. Thank you. And you go out. And you continue the day. And you do something more. In a small ashram, in his ashram, his ashram, he's the Siddha, he's the God. So you whom you do seva? To God. How great it is, how meaningful it is, how auspicious it is. The potential is there because if he loves you because you dedicated, he will do for you. Means you can achieve everything. Doesn't matter what is your karmas. It doesn't matter. He's the God. What is more great than God? There is no great more than God. And then come the night, and Gurudev told you to put bhajans before the arati. So this bhajan I like. Oh, it was yesterday. Doesn't matter, I like it. But I know that the villagers like these dead bhajans. Oh, I like it. Okay, they are not coming. But they can hear. And maybe it will inspire someone to come. This is maybe the right thought. That you want to spread the mission, the name, the greatness of your God. You want to spread it. Why? Because it will help more people. So either you say, no, I love this bhajan, or you say, no, I will achieve someone to come today, maybe. Or someone more. Because someone came already. And you gave him, give the prasad, you gave him the time. You offered him something. You made a contact, your relation. You gave him a feeling that he is wanted. You forgot yourself with some thing to do for yourself, and you attended the moment that someone came. It's generating energy. It's generating blessing. It's generating respect to you. If you think about this or not, this is him. He is doing it. He is doing it. If not, you will not. Okay, you are in a small ashram. How great it is. God's ashram. I am there. Yes, yes, I'm in Kailash ashram. You don't know. It depends on you. How is the ashram? Not on anyone else. God will guide you. But he will not do the things for you. You will need to fix the things. You will need to take care of the plumbing and the electricity. And if you cannot do, you call the mystery, the professional. So you put it the bhajans and you did a prayer and then you go to have your dinner, dinner. And dinner is over and then you go to sleep and then maybe it's too long, so and then one day is over in an ashram. Did you gain something? Did you learn something? Did you achieve something? If not, it's a pity. Small ashram, you didn't take the benefit of it. You were in some place for you, not in an ashram. So, take it serious. If you are in a big ashram or small ashram, take it serious. The potential is there. It depends on us. Dev Purishama, Deva Kidze, Sialak Purisha Bhagavana Kidze, Deep Narayan Bhagavana Kidze, Dharam Samratsama Davananda Ji Bhagavana Kidze, Vishwaguru Mamandaleshwa Swami Maheshwarananda Ji Gurudeva Kidze.
Our dear Swami Haripuriji, great. It was from the heart. The reality, the truth. It is very, very great lecture what he did today. Thank you. Sleep today good? Tomorrow will be again. Deepnar Bhagwan ki jai.
Sri Deva Purisha Mahadeva Dayala. Sri Deva Purisha Mahadeva Dayala. Kailash Puri me rehne wala, Kailash Puri me rehne wala. Sri Deva Purisha Mahadeva Dayala. Sri Deva Purisha Mahadeva Dayala. Oh.